So before we move on, I wanted to talk a little bit more about classes. So here we've used a class called different in order to be able to identify just this particular tag inside of a selector. So one way to think about classes is that they themselves are a category or something similar to what you would do when you tag some kind of content, like pictures in Facebook, when you're tagging pictures with friends of yours so that those people's feeds will show that picture. In the same way, classes are just intended to categorize a tag. The name of the category itself doesn't mean anything. Instead, we give it meaning by using it as a selector inside of our CSS. You'll also find later on, as you work with JavaScript, that you can use classes as an identifier to manipulate the HTML. Even though we're only using one class here, we can apply multiple classes. So if we just added a space right here, we could add another class called highlighted. The space is just a separator between multiple class names, and you can use any number of class names, 2, 10, 20. And when it comes to creating selectors, you can use the classes together or separately in order to identify what styles to apply to which elements. So even though this has a class of different and a class of highlighted, this selector here will apply to it because it does have the different class. However, if we also had an H2 that had a class of different, but didn't have a class of highlighted, then it would apply to this H2 as well. However, we could be specific to just this H2 by stringing the class names together in the selector. So here we have .different, and without adding a space, we can do .highlighted, and now these styles here will apply only to elements that have both different and highlighted classes. As you work with HTML and CSS more, you'll get a better feel for what you can do here. But I wanted to illustrate just how flexible this is, and also how arbitrary. At some point soon, you're going to start feeling a little unsure about what class names you should use and what selectors you should use. And that's because it's one of the hardest things to do in CSS. When you choose a class name, what you're doing is identifying what makes this element or a group of elements different than other elements. And finding the right word or phrase to describe that is actually rather hard sometimes. Sometimes you don't know why it's different, it's just different in the design. And then figuring out which selectors to use is sometimes even more challenging. Because to create the right selector, you have to know when exactly a particular style is going to apply. And especially at the beginning of the templating process, that's not always going to be obvious. So just know that if you get tripped up trying to figure out what class names to use or what selectors to use, that you're in good company. It's tough to figure those things out. And a lot of times what you need to do is just pick something and move forward. And then you can come back later once you know more about what it is that you're actually trying to do and rewrite them so they make more sense with the template. All right, I'm going to undo everything we just did. All right, let's go back to our template so far. Remember, we've just changed the border to white, and we're about to refresh in the browser to see what it looks like.